Center of gravity. This is the position where the torque due to gravity to gravity can be calculated. And it's generally at the center of mass. Center of mass, where the average position of everything, so like my scissors here, so let's say if I tried to balance them, let's see, oh, let me see if I can balance them on a marker. It would be right about, right there. So you can kind of see that's where the center of mass is. It's also where the center of gravity is at the moment. It's generally at the center of mass, except where you have like a very tall building. So the most famous example would be the where before the Twin Towers fell, or one of the Twin Towers. So you had the Twin Towers, that was the one like that. So the center of mass was located here, but then the center of gravity was located. Whoops, I used the wrong hand. So the center of the CM would be there, but actually the CG was down here. The center of gravity was actually 2 centimeters below the center of mass because gravity changed so much. When we take a look at the gravitational field, right, the gravitational field, here's the gravitational field. They look parallel, but really they're not. They're farther apart up here than they are down here, and it was measurable enough across the Twin Towers to make a difference. Well, what does that look like when we go to calculate? Let's go back to our diving problem where now the board has mass. So our free body, we remember we're trying to find out the force due to one. This is force due to one, I think, believe was, oh shoot, I think I want to say it was over here. And this is the force due to two. So here was F2 and here's F1. I think F1 was over here. So how do I calculate that now when the board has mass? So let's draw our free body diagram. So now I have the force due to Lubbs, I have the force due to two, I have the force due to one, but then I need to calculate the mass of the board in there. So the board, where's my red? The board is going to have the force due to the board. It's going to be in there as well, the force due to the board, and that's going to equal the weight of the board. So, I'm sorry, m of the board times g. So there, now my free body diagram has an extra value inside of it, and now my torque diagram, rule of four, let's see, let's draw this out. There's my board. Let's draw the force due to Lubbs. Where's my colors? All right. Force due to Lubbs is over here. The force due to the board is here. The F2 is here. And now F1 is here. So now when I go to sum my torques, I have to bring in the force due to the board. So let's put our axis in. I think I originally did this. My axis was in here. So that means my axis is here. So now when I go to sum of my torques equals zero, and that equals the torque due to one plus the torque due to two plus the torque due to, let's see, this way is positive. So F2 is positive. Torque due to the board is going to be negative. Negative torque due to the board and negative the torque due to the Lubbs. So for your homework this evening, find out F1 and F2, including the torque due to the board.